दो पंचे दस, दो छक्का बारह, दो सत्ते चौदह.
In the 19th century lived a woman called Savitribai. She's a pioneer for feminists in our country. You might have heard her briefly mentioned in your history textbooks, but do you realize she sparked a revolution of women's education in India? Savitribai was born in Naigaon, Maharashtra in 1831. She belonged to a Shudra caste. In 1840, when she was only 10 years old, she was married off to Jyotiba Phule, who was also only 13 years old at that time. From a tender age, Savitribai showed an interest in educating herself, which for a woman, especially from an oppressed caste, was nothing short of revolutionary. Jyotiba assisted her in her effort, teaching her to read and write. Even though education was a product made for and by upper caste men, Savitribai would not let the casteist and sexist system stop her in her pursuit of education. After completing her education, Savitribai began training to be a teacher. In 1847, she passed all her exams and became certified to be a teacher. In 1848, Savitribai and Jyotiba Phule started the first Indian-run school for girls in Bhidewada, Pune, making Savitribai the first Indian woman to become a teacher and headmistress. Of course, the upper castes did not take kindly to a Bahujan woman teaching and educating girls. On her way to school, Savitribai would have stones, mud and cow dung pelted at her. It is said that she would carry two saris when she went to school, changing out of the soiled sari once she reached school. She would say, "As I do the sacred task of teaching my fellow sisters, the stones or cow dung that you throw at me seem like flowers. May God bless you." Due to the outrage at their work, Savitribai and Jyotiba Phule were thrown out of their house by Jyotiba's father. Still resolute, they moved and opened another school for adults in Pune for the Dalit Bahujan community at the house of Usman Sheikh and his sister Fatima Sheikh. They taught at the school with Fatima Sheikh, who became the first Muslim woman teacher of India. From a single school with 8 girls in 1848, Savitribai was running 3 schools with about 150 girls by 1851. A report on the Pune Observer in 1852 read, "The number of girls in Jyoti Rao's girls' school is 10 times more than the number of boys in government schools. This is because the system for teaching girls is far superior to what is available to boys from the government schools." In 1852, Savitribai started a women's rights organization called Mahila Seva Mandal and organized a successful barber strike to protest the practice of shaving widows' heads. Savitribai was also a poet and wrote poetry stressing on the need for education and the oppression faced by marginalized castes. In 1863, she started an infanticide prohibition home for pregnant widows to provide them a safe space to give birth without the fear of society. The Phules themselves adopted the son of Kashibai, a Brahmin widow. He was named Yashwant Rao and went on to become a doctor. When Jyoti Rao passed away on November 28, 1890, Savitribai broke all norms when she lit his funeral pyre. She also took over the running of their social organization, Satya Shodhak Samaj. In 1897, a wave of bubonic plague hit Nalasopara. While taking care of the afflicted, Savitribai contracted the disease herself. She succumbed to the disease and died on March 10, 1897. Her legacy has been memorialized in statues, stamps, university names, and in books and films. Women's education in India is indebted to the tireless work of Savitribai Phule. Shouldn't January 3rd, her birth anniversary, be celebrated as Teachers' Day?